Tractate Orla, Perek Echad, Mishnah Bet. Tractate Orla, first chapter, second Mishnah. Et Shebau Avotenu La'aretz, at the time that our forefathers came into the land of Israel, this is the time of Yehoshua bin Nun, Matz'u natua, they found the land with trees, with planted trees. Ilan shematz'u patur, any tree that they found which was already planted, haya patur min orla, was not obligated from orla. Why? Because it says on Vaikra Yutet Chaf Gimel, it says, V'chitavou el ha'aretz, when you're going to come to the land, unetatem kol etz ma'achal, and you're going to plant all fruit tree, prat leshenat ogoyim kodem shebatem la'aretz. This came to exclude all the trees that the Gentile planted before we came into the land. Nat o, if he planted it, ben Israel, ben Goyim, whether he was a Jew, whether he was a non-Jew, le'achar shenichnasu la'aretz, after they entered the land, afal pi shelo kibshu, even though they did not conquer the entire land, chayav ha'ilan be'orla, the tree is obligated in all the laws of Orla. Shenemar, because it says, V'chi tavou el aretz, when you're going to come to the land, Misha'a shetavou el aretz, from the time they enter the land, Chal chiyuv erla al ilan ma'achal shetetu. At that moment, the obligation of Orla comes on any fruit tree that they planted. U'mima shenemar kol etz darshu. Why does it say all fruit, all trees? It could just say tree without the word all. The word all is redundant. What do we learn from the word all? So the sages learn from it, benat o Israel ben hagoy, whether a Jew planted the tree, it's obligated in Ola. Whether a non-Jew planted the tree, it's also obligated in Ola. Hanotea lerabim, if somebody planted the tree for the sake of the many, not for his own use, but for public consumption, sheyuchlu kulam miperotav, that everybody can enjoy from those fruits. And the Rambam adds, ki'ilu hefkir et haperot, it is like he gave away all the fruits. The Mishnah says, Chayav be'orla, he is still obligated in the laws of Orla. Shenemar, because the verse says, Unetatem, and you planted, which means even to the many, even to the multitudes. Rabbi Yehuda Poter, Rabbi Yehuda says, in such a case where you planted for the multitude, you're not obligated. Shenemar, because he looks at the verse, at the words, Yihye lachem arelim, it would be to you closed. Vesover Rabbi Yehuda, and Rabbi Yehuda learns, we have over here a case of ribui achar ribui, inclusion after inclusion. And he learns that when you have an inclusion after an inclusion, it comes to take away. It comes to exclude. New case. Hanotea bereshut rabim. If one plants in the public domain, but he plants for his own use, he's going to use the product. Ve'anochri shenata, and a non-Jew that planted, yesh mefarshim shenata besadeu shel Israel. There are those who explain this part, that he planted in a field of a Jew, ve'yesh mefarshim afilu nata la'atzmo, those who explain it, that he, if even if he planted for himself, והגזלן שנטע, and somebody who took over a field by force and he planted, והנוטע בספינה, and somebody who plants inside a boat, אף על פי שאינה נקובה, even though there's no hole in the boat, אם היא של חרס, if it is made out of clay, שכן השורשים מפעפעים דרך החרס ויונקים מן הקרקע, because the roots can go through the clay and attach to the ground. ברם, but, אם היא של עץ, if the boat was made out of wood, then it is necessary, צריך שתהיה נקובה, it is necessary for it to be with a hole. ויש מפרשים, and there are those who explain, בן של עץ, בן של חרס, אף על פי שאין נקובה. Whether it was of wood, whether it was of clay, even though it wasn't hauled. והעולה מאליו, and any tree, אילן שצמח ועלה מאליו ברשות היחיד, that grew by its own in the private domain, כל אחד מאלה, all of the above examples that we gave, חייב בעולה. Is obligated in Orla. Perotav, בשלוש שנים הראשונות, which means the fruits are forbidden in the first 3 years, and they are forbidden because of the laws of Orla.